Love from love, beloved. Welcome to the truth about the rapture. The rapture has always been misunderstood, and I did too for many years, but undeniable proof of the truth of the rapture finally exists when you piece together all the different prophecy concerning it. So love from love, hope from hope, and peace from peace, our Prince of Peace thereof, who comes forth on the cloud of the splendor of his own magnificence. His love goes before him. He is the sower of the seeds of love, who has now overtaken his reaper of his harvest. These are the days of the everlasting gospel that I have written. Hear it for yourself. Punch in YouTube the manifested everlasting gospel of Revelation 14 and see if it's not a gospel of creation that sounds exactly like Moses, that Moses foretold that one like him would come, Deuteronomy 18:18. Judge for yourself, but one thing's for sure, the rapture has been totally misunderstood, people. The Lord is going to save this earth from the oblivion at hand that he has promised in his word to keep us from days as Noah's. A literal oblivion of Matthew 24:2, Malachi 4:6, Deuteronomy 18:18, Zephaniah 1, Isaiah 24, the whole chapter. And the bottom line is the Lord's love will save the day through us. And for that reason, the peace of Isaiah 2 of the latter days is at hand. And because peace comes, a rapture shall not be necessary, because there have been two totally separate, opposite futures foretold in the Word of God. The latter day future of peace in Isaiah 2 and the Armageddon of Zechariah 6. Nuclear, where eyes and tongues consume away in the mouth and the socket as flesh consumes away as people stand. Two futures cannot exist at the same time, and they've always been pieced together wrong. People did not understand that prophecy was not to foretell the future, but to make the future and to make a future of peace so that the kingdom age can come. Because if the people of earth unite in love and have their love stirred up, we shall overcome. We are the children of the victor of victory. Thus saith the Lord. So it's time to continue on, and continue on must we. So I therefore read you 1 Corinthians 15. And it says this, people. He says, behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, would this happen. Now, if you know the book of Revelation, the last trump is the seventh trump. And when the seventh trump sounds, all Israel is saved. The mystery of God is over. And the mystery of God is finished, and all nations become the Lord's. Just read Revelation 10. And when that seventh perfect trumpet sounds, the dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall all be changed. This is literal, and it's true, and it's metaphoric at the same time. For with the last trump, the perfect trump being given, because it was last, it was first. The first is last, the last is first. And because of this, when the last trump, in a twinkling of an eye, when it's given and the perfect sounded, all people are changed, because finally the kingdom age covenant comes for all people. And we know our future is only one of exaltation and bliss, everlasting love, because of the word of love in our hearts. So always remember that in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, this would happen. And the last trump has sounded, people. The trump is the perfect trumpet. And because I am the covenant messenger, and now I Ephesians 5:1, and I've given the message to all mankind as it was originally intended. And that's what it says, straight out, that God says, I am the Lord God of Israel and all mankind. Jeremiah 32:27. And because it got switched, so too that all of our understanding is welcome to the voice and the blessing of Joanne McFadder. And now there is an invitation. And the invitation is to come up higher, to ascend into the rapture. For the rapture is upon us. All hearing his word of love will immediately be with the Lord on that cloud of Isaiah, of Revelation 14, and the cloud of Matthew 24. For his word opens, reopens, as Daniel 12:4 told, in the end times, to keep us from the oblivion of Matthew 24:22. For unless the kingdom age started, no flesh could be saved, according to the word of the Lord. And his word comes to teach us and to bring us up higher into the ways of heaven. When I manifested all, rapture is a love. That's what rapture has meant. It has been misunderstood throughout the years, and it was purposely put in a metaphorical way that people, the mystery of God was a veil that covered over the entire Bible. And the Lord allowed this in his permissible will, for people to be misled the last 2,000 years and have nothing but desolate heritages, as Isaiah 49:8-4 told. But one thing's for sure, you know, a lot of people have said that no one will be in the rapture without the Holy Ghost. Whoever has the Holy Ghost are those of love. Those who love are born of God and know God, because God is love, is the literal true word of love. So it's all been in our definitions have been wrong. And so there's assurance. And so the Lord gives us assurance of his love everlasting. And the Lord says, he says, I will come back and take you to be with me. And he is coming to earth again. The Bible tells us so. And in the book of Malachi, he shall return to his third temple that the Jewish people are trying their best to erect. But insofar as a rapture coming, it's total non-needed. It's not even needed, because love is going to save this earth. And from the edge of oblivion, Christ's word coming again on the cloud of Matthew 24, with his kingdom age new covenant being given to all mankind, as it is written, his word of love shall overflow and save this earth for those that believe in love. So dead or alive, the rapture is coming. Rich or poor, the rapture is coming. And the rapture is here, my brothers and my sisters, the rapture of love. Because if you can agree to disagree with other people and look for our commonalities between us and them, then can start the age of reason, the golden age, the kingdom age of peace. And all that opposes the message that I bring are fully antichrist and do not want to worship the Lord in full truth. They do not believe that our Buddhist brothers love or know God. They do not believe that our Hindu brothers know God and love. They do not believe the Jews love. They do not believe anybody loves except themselves. Division and strife and nothing but an accusing religion has Christianity wrongly become. But the truth is, beloved, that an everlasting gospel has to come forth with John the Beloved's words. He prophesied this in Revelation 14, that his words, not mine, must go again to all people, to all nations, to all because people didn't get it the first time, that those who love are born of God and do know God, because God is love. And all knees shall bow, and all tongues shall confess love. That is His name, capital L. And for God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten love, so that whosoever believeth in love shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, when the seventh trump sounds and resounds throughout the circle of earth, people will not have to continue along the path of sleeping and being awake. Can now come. So arise and shine. The glory of the Lord is coming and arising as the Son of Love to destroy the gross darkness of religion. This then is the shattering of the power of the holy people of Daniel 7, prophesied to be brought forth by the latter-day Daniel of Daniel 12:13, who I am. Daniel of Windsor, Ontario, Canada, from the north. And the influence of love through me, as Isaiah 41 predicted, will become as the mortar upon the leaders of the world. They are the bricks, and the influence of love shall change this world and be as the mortar upon them, saith the Lord. These are great days. And the Lord says, behold, I have shown you a mystery in times past. And this is in the word of God. But the people denying everything that I'm saying are denying that there's even been a mystery. And the mystery is now unraveled and clear. It's been made plain upon the tablet, so that they who readeth it may run, and those who may hear it will be like Mickey and Minnie in my good story times, and have eyes to see and big ears to hear with. Maybe the bigger our ears, the better we can hear. But all creation is changed in the twinkling of an eye when the last trump sounds, the perfect trump. Because when the perfect trump sounds, the mystery of God is over. And He says to all of His creation, to all people, everyone that breathes the breath of love that He first gave them, He says, I shall forgive your iniquity. I shall remember it no more. Satan to the pit for 1,000 years. He can never be the accuser of the brethren again. And I shall write the law of love upon all hearts. And all people no more shall ever need to be taught about me. For the least to the greatest and everyone in between of this whole world shall know me, even as fish know water that keeps them alive. And He is the living water in this age, and I am but His messenger. And He comes forth from the heavens, and the white horse of Revelation 6 rides, and He carries a long bow, and His weapon is the servant of Isaiah 49. For it is written that He has made me to be as a sharpest arrow. And people, everything I'm saying lines up. I'm going to be ignored here at the Daniel Owsley channel for some time, it appears, because people are scared to death of love. And it doesn't make sense. It's contradictory. But all the understandings of mankind have been taught wrong. And the Lord knew that the restoration of His word, by only His word, self-interpreting itself, would have to come. And this I do bring now. And I am Elijah that restores all things. So it's time that we got to stop looking for signs of the times and the heavens and listen for the sound of the seventh trumpet. He says to all, I am coming soon. Be alert at all times. Pray that so that you have the power to escape hatefulness. Because that's all that people need to escape. Because this world is going to be saved from its oblivion, saith the Lord. And the Son of Man is the Son of Love, who comes forth in the glory of the brilliance of the resplendence of His own magnificence. And He is the Beneficent One. One thing's for sure, that many people have only known darkness all their lives. And life without a past or a future is what they thought that everything was. Murphy's Law, if it can go wrong, it will. It does, but no, because the Lord has given his word from on high, and from his great white throne overflowingly comes the word of love on the cloud of Matthew 24, his love over all people. And he says, without question, all those who love are born of him and know him because he is love. And he forgives all iniquity and remembers it no more. And for all those believing in a judgment day of wrath and condemnation, it does not exist, never has. For if God judged any of us that have our love light on, then he would be a liar and all religion would be at naught for nothing. So God has never knows untruth, and I am his latter-day messenger. So please understand that I come not to do away with the law or the gospel or the rapture or anything. A rapture is an escapism that I used to believe in until the Lord gave open-eyed visions to me and revealed to me that the truth of Isaiah 45, for it came about that one day the Lord said unto my heart, he said, of things concerning the future of my sons and daughters, the future of a rapture, and I wanted to know about that, and the work of your hands, command ye me, what's going to happen? I wanted to know, so I did command him, and next thing I know, I'm writing by a lamp that was never plugged in for about seven, 8 minutes, actually. It had to be longer than 5 minutes. And I'm groping around in the dark on the ceiling light and realize it was way too loose ever to come on. And then I look down and it's like, oh my God, that was the light that was on. And it was way away from the plug. So the Lord has shown me through open-eyed visions, and the breath of God has breathed upon me, people. You can take this to the bank. There's YouTubers out there like Blue Heaven, a sweet lady, but she's misled, thinking escapism is going to happen every day and God's just going to miraculously rescue us from this world, when it's his love alone that will save us from us, because we are the future that we seek, and we are the change that we need. But we must act, and we must be united in love. We must look at our commonalities rather than our differences, and know that every single person ever born that has their love light on is our brothers and sisters in love, and that we are one and united in love that he sends. Amen.